Yeah, but what else is there?
This place.
This place. It's a coffee shop.
Sure, what's wrong with that? Nobody ever robs restaurants. Why not? Bars, shops, you get your head blown off robbing them. But restaurants, no one's ever expecting it. And they're insured, just like the banks.
Manager doesn't give a shit. Customers? Sure, the customers are too busy stuffing their mouths. They've any idea what's going on.
1 second, they're tucking into their Denver omelette. The next second, someone's sticking a gun in their face. Do you remember that last liquor store we stuck up? All those customers kept coming in.
Yeah.
And you had the idea to take their wallets. Now that was a good idea.
Thank you.
Sure, in the end, we made more from the wallets than we did from the register. Look around. A lot of people come to restaurants.
A lot of wallets.
Pretty smart, huh?
Pretty smart. Okay, I'm ready. Let's shoot right here, right now.
Okay, same as before. You do crowd control, I'll handle the employees.
Got it. Oh, I love you, pumpkin.
I love you, honey bun.
Everybody be cool. This is a robbery.
Any of you fucking pricks move, and I'll execute every last one of you.
I just want you to know how sorry we are about how fucked up things got between ourselves and Mr. Wallace. When we got into this thing, we only had the best of intentions.
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I break your concentration? You were saying something about best intentions? Do you read the Bible, Brett?
Yeah.
There's this passage I got memorized. Seems appropriate for this situation. Ezekiel 25:17. The path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the inequities of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men. Blessed is he who, in the name of charity and goodwill, shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness, for he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger those who attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon thee.
I made the song.
So what do you think happened to Antoine?
He fell out a window.
One way to say it. Another way, he was thrown by your husband, Marcellus. And even another way, he was thrown out a window by Marcellus because of you.
Who told you that?
They.
They talk a lot, don't they?
They certainly do.
So don't be shy, Vincent. What exactly did they say?
They said Antoine gave you a foot massage.
You heard Marcellus threw Antoine out of a four-story building because he massaged my feet?
Yeah.
And you believed it? The only thing Antoine ever touched of mine was my hand when he shook it. I met Antoine once at my wedding and then never again. The truth is, nobody knows why Marcellus tossed Antoine out of that four-story building except Marcellus and Antoine.
Ladies and gentlemen, now the moment you've all been waiting for, the world-famous Jackrabbit Slim Twist Contest. Now, who will be our first contestants?
Right here!
No.
I do believe Marcellus, my husband, your boss, asked you to take me out and do whatever I wanted. Now, I want to dance. I want to win. I want that trophy.
All right.
So dance good.
Right, now let's meet our first contestants. Young lady, what is your name?
Mrs. Mia Wallace.
And how about your fellow over here?
Vincent Vega.
Right, now let's see what you can do. Take it away.
It was a teenage wedding and the old folks wished them well. You could see that Pierre did truly love the mademoiselle. And now the young monsieur and madame have rung the chapel bell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, it goes to show you never can tell. They furnished off an apartment with a two-room robot sale. The coolerator was crammed with TV dinners and ginger ale. come and worked out well. C'est la vie, say the old folks, the culture show you never can tell. They had a hi-fi phone, oh boy, did they let it blast. 700 little records, all rock, rhythm, and jazz. But when the sun went down, the rapid tempo of the music fell. C'est la vie, say the old folks, the culture show you never can tell. They bought a souped up chitney, was a cherry red 53. Drove it down to Orleans to celebrate the anniversary.
No!
Let me be the one you come.
So, if you're quitting the life, what'll you do?
That's what I've been sitting here contemplating. First, I'm gonna deliver this case to Marcellus. Then, basically, I'm gonna walk the earth.
What do you mean, walk the earth?
You know, like Kane and Kung Fu. Gonna walk from town to town, meet people, get in adventures.
So you decided to be a bum?
No, just Jules, Vincent. No more, no less.
No Jules. No job, residence, or legal tender. You're gonna be a fucking bum. I gotta take a shit.
Now everybody be cool! This is a robbery!
Any of you fucking pricks move and I'll execute every last one of you!
Customers, stay seated. Waitresses on the floor.
Now means fucking now! Do it or die! Do it or fucking die!
Okay, I'm gonna come around. Collect your wallets. Toss them in the bag. Don't talk. We clear? What's in the briefcase?
My boss's dirty laundry.
Open it up.
I'm afraid I can't do that.
Let him go!
Tell the bitch to be cool. Say bitch be cool. Bitch be cool.
Chill out, honey, chill out.
Normally, both your ass would be dead as fried chicken by now. But you happen to pull this shit while I'm in a transitional period. I don't want to kill you, I want to help you. Now go in that bag and take out my wallet.
Which one is it?
The one that says badass motherfucker. Now, open it up, take out the cash. Put it in the pocket. It's yours.
Jules, if you give this fucking Nimrod 1500, I'm gonna shoot him on general principle.
I ain't giving him the money. I'm buying something. You wanna know what I'm buying, Ringo? I'm giving you this money so I don't have to kill your ass. Do you read the Bible? There's this passage I got memorized. Ezekiel 25:17. The path of the righteous man is beset on all sides by the iniquities of the selfish and the tyranny of evil men. Blessed is he who in the name of charity and goodwill shepherds the weak through the valley of darkness, for he is truly his brother's keeper and the finder of lost children. And I will strike down upon thee with great vengeance and furious anger those who attempt to poison and destroy my brothers. And you will know my name is the Lord when I lay my vengeance upon you. I've been saying that shit for years. Never really questioned what it meant. Now, it could mean that you're the evil man, and I'm the righteous man. And Mr. 45 here, he's the shepherd protecting my righteous ass through the valley of darkness. You're the weak, and I'm the tyranny of evil men. But I'm trying, Ringo, I'm trying real hard to be the shepherd. Talking to me, you come and tell me everything is all right. You kiss and tell me everything's all right. Can I get away again tonight? The only one who could ever reach me.
I think we ought to leave now.